Here's something inspiring for your day. I'm standing here in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, outside the Wake Forest Institute for Regenerative Medicine. Here they build new tissues for us, and ultimately they're going to build new organs for us out of our own cells, using our cells like Lego building blocks. There are 400 people in this building, basically working on transforming the entirety of human medicine. For about 20 years, they've been making simple containers, such as bladders and urethra, and different tubes in our bodies as replacement components. They started hand building them, then they introduced bioprinting technology, and now it's a combination of those methods and even methods to build components inside the body by adding the right signals and proteins and the right shapes and lattices to do the repairs in situ, if you like. So imagine a future in which our hospitals all have facilities to help build us new spare parts, and then you understand what they're working on here. But they're going further than that. They're already making bold contributions to medicine because they're producing tissues like lung tissue. I just had a look at a sample of lung tissue that had been built here. So it could be used with chemical tests to improve, for example, the safety of soldiers on the battlefield. They're already contributing the technologies they're building in this facility here to other medical facilities to do new things with tissue regeneration. So there's all sorts of directions in which they're going, and ultimately they're going to change all of our lives by making it possible to replace and rebuild parts of our bodies, either in situ or outside. But as you can appreciate, the complexity of building a kidney with something like 30 different cell types, including all of those little blood vessels and all of the nerves that have to operate exactly right to make it work, is incredible. So they're knocking over one little problem at a time, and they're working at a fundamental science level, experimenting to see what works and what tissues can be built first and what will grow next and so forth. Now, I find that incredibly inspiring, and I just wanted to share that with you today because this is my second visit to this lab. I came here 3 years ago, so I've had a sense now of the progress that's being made.